know the targets, the areas for, that would fall under safety?
So.
You have a list of those?
Yeah, so safety, like what Matt mentioned, 11 dirt roads, an obvious one. Division Street's obvious.
Pleasant Grove Road even, because of sharp curves.
Yeah, Pleasant Grove's a great.
There was just a wreck there today or yesterday.
There's wrecks there all the time.
Right in front of Catalpa.
Yeah. So let's take Pleasant Grove, for instance. Let's compare it to, say, how would Pleasant Grove meet safety? Well, crashes there, congestion, we know it's going to be connecting to an interchange where we may not have the congestion today, but we're planning for that. Economic opportunity, I think Pleasant Grove Road would be an obvious one for economic opportunity.
Okay, how do you factor this in when you know, yeah, Pleasant Grove Road's probably going to an interchange, but you know it's going to be 15 to 20 years before the interchange is ever there? So.
Well, we're not, we wouldn't, so I would say that would be with connectivity. Are you talking about, is it going to be connected, and what I stated there? Connect sewer provides a connection between existing or other, existing facilities for the project. We're not going to say, we know the Central Pike interchange is hanging out there, and we know that TDOT's working on that. It's in the Improve Act, it's committed to be funding, to be funded. Our take on it is that we're not going to build a bridge to nowhere. We want to build a bridge to a project that we know is going to be there, at least in short order. If we can time them together, that'd be fantastic.
But that's not going to be short order.
Well.
I mean, the Improve Act is also there for my Lebanon Road project. It's been 7 years in the making. So, you know, it's hard for me to believe that they're going to have anything quicker than 7 years.
Well, and this, so this wouldn't take into account delays on projects that may be sitting out there that we may not have control over. But what it would take into account is basically us stating this is our local priority from a funding standpoint. That would be my point that I would say. If we had two projects, let's say we had Pleasant Grove Road and we had East Division. You had two projects and they came in and you went through and you go through scoring them. Which one do you do first? You look at the score, you see what the priority is. You got to pick one over the other when it comes down to it. If you're sitting there with the decision of money, now how we've got $30 million to spend, are we going to spend it on Pleasant Grove or are we going to spend it on Division? So, you know, at some point in time, we're not there today, but at some point in time, we're going to have to make a decision between projects. And this is the beginning point of that, that at some point in time, we're going to reach a fiscal year. It's not going to be this next year either, but we're going to reach a fiscal year eventually that we're going to have to say, what are we going to pay for in this year? And this is to set the foundation for that. It's not the final decision. It is to come out with a capital plan. It is to get a rough idea of the years of which we would be building something. And it's not to say we wouldn't do a project. It's to say that, well, that one may not score as well as this one, so let's put it in a following year after this other one. So that's the general idea of it. We'll take the categories, come out with it, and then basically evaluate the projects. And then, you know, the only thing I might say is you might have a project that gets no points. If that's the case, I might bring it to the commission and say, you know, this project didn't score well at all. Is this something we want to pursue? You know, of course, you know, if you get something with grant money, it might change the game. We're not necessarily pursuing local sidewalk repair projects on Mount Juliet Road without grant money. We're relying on those with grant money, but roadway projects we are. And so the conversation is going to be different for each type of project category.
Do you have a list of the details of what each one, like, further explains?
I can probably just answer in question form. A lot of these are very kind of what meets the eye. You know, I could run down through it. Safety, obviously, is crash history. That's a measurable nature that you could look at there. You may not even have crash history, but you could have unsafe conditions, steep drop-offs, Division Street. You know, let's just say Division Street didn't have a bad crash history, but anybody looking at it can say that's a dangerous situation. If you fall off that road, you're in serious trouble. So you could say definitely that's a safety issue. Grant funding is pretty obvious. It's a yes or a no. Congestion is what I would say is primary purpose on that. Do we have a congested roadway? And one thing that I would say, give an example for congestion, would be to say, I included relieve congestion or on parallel facilities. So let's take the Western Connector type roadway that we're looking at. The purpose of that is to relieve north-south congestion on Mount Juliet Road. So yes, I would say that's a congestion relief because that's the purpose of it. Readiness and impacts, let's use Western Connector again. How ready is that project to be built versus maybe a project that might be something that would be within the right-of-way? Replacing an existing sidewalk, for instance, would have high marks because you're just going to be staying within the right-of-way to do that work. But a brand-new roadway going cross-country and crossing a creek or wetlands or things like that is going to have some pretty serious impacts. I would say even our larger projects with the Improve Act, Lebanon Road, Mount Juliet Road, they have pretty significant environmental property and utility impacts on those projects, so they take a long time. They're not ready to be built today. Probably the question I would ask is it shovel ready today, or could it be within a couple of years? A signal would probably be get better marks for something like that than a new road would. Connectivity, I would state on that, Mount Juliet Road, bridge, bless you.
Thank you.
Bridge widening would be a fantastic example of connectivity. You had lanes that were dropping into a left turn lane. You had no bicycle lanes going across the road, no sidewalks going across the bridge there. You had a disjointed roadway because of a limited bridge width, and so the widening of that bridge did provide a logical connection. you know, same thing, if you've got a road project that's connecting, Pleasant Grove would be a great one. It's going to connect to at least, we know, projects that will be out there in the future, be it what it may with the timing of the interchange or Central Pike widening. We know it's going to connect, and we know it's going to connect to a road that's already in good shape today in front of Walmart.
Western Connector is another good one.
Yeah.
It has connector in its name. Connecting the west side of town.
Yeah.
Between Lebanon Road and the interstate.
Transportation plan consistency, you know, is it a project that we identified in our comprehensive transportation plan? That's what CTP stands for. Or if it's not in there, is it going to be generally consistent with it? Maybe it was a low priority type project. But those things can change too. I mean, it could be a low priority and one development comes in and it elevates it to top priority. And so, you know, that one could be up for, that one's probably the one I'd say with the change, with how things can change with developments, that could change that category a little bit, but in general, that would be the idea. And the idea is that we put a plan out there, we approved it, we want to kind of stick to it. Otherwise, what good are we? And then the last, economic opportunity. Wanted to take a look at that one. I mentioned Pleasant Grove Road, it's one I've got in mind.
Yep.
I think in some small ways, division could be, but with it, you know, economic opportunity, what level of involvement potentially could there be of developments to pay back into it, which could fold back into grant money. And with grant money, what I did want to mention, we typically think federal or state, but East Division's one that's got $7 million now from Amazon. And as developments come on, I know Commissioner Heffner and I have talked about it, of having other developments, and I'd say it'd be agreeable with the board, is having other developments pile in on that. And so that we can actually get some measurable dollars to get that project going sooner rather than later. Yeah. That's just ways to pay for this. You know, that's just something to think about as ways to pay for it. But then I wanted to leave one open for interpretation as far as there may be something I missed. What I did is I looked at prioritizations from other cities
and what they've done, as well as GNRC, when they developed the transportation plan, the recently passed 2045 transportation plan. So I wanted to try to borrow from theirs where I felt like it was appropriate. But there may be something that I missed.
What about traffic lighting technology, or because that also factors into congestion and.
Yeah.
Not everything is blamed on roads.
Mm-hmm.
Congestion can be out of sync signals.
Right, it can be. Well, and so the idea when I presented this back in November is to put these into different silos for transportation, but then also for other projects as well. We're gonna have stormwater, we have sewer, and then we've got our also facilities. So to say that, okay, here's our road silo, and here's our ranking from top to bottom, and then here's our signal systems, which would include lighting, intelligent systems, which we just got a grant for.
Congratulations, Bob.
I appreciate it. Matt did the hard work on that. By the way, on both of those grants, here's your guy.
$2 million.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think all together with that and Greenway 3.5 plus. So, but that one grant, the signal system grant, by the way, 100% for all the signal work. There's a little bit of local money that we'll have to put in for ADA ramps, maybe. Might get TDOT to pay for that. I think we will. But with that one would achieve the purpose of congestion, I would say, number one. There is a safety aspect that comes with helping out with congestion. That's a good, but then I would say grant funding would score very well. So that project is all of a sudden with the grant money going to shoot way up the list. And it doesn't mean that we fund it or not, but you know, that's a good example of a project all of a sudden receives grant funding. These things change every year, and that's why I want to try to develop something, and we can massage it year after year, but develop something where, okay, Project X, well, we got some grant money on this year, or we got a developer that threw $5 million into this project this year. All of a sudden, this project shoots up the list on our priorities, and that will help us make better decisions as we fund these, I'd say particularly for construction. That we can fund every single project we've got for engineering right now and not worry a bit about money and where we're sitting right now. Our problem is going to be once we get down into doing a lot of the right-of-way acquisition, and then especially into construction. And that's where we're really going to have to be making those decisions. So this is the idea that we're coming up with, set that where we can come up with. I know y'all may or may not still have your booklets, but that we handed out, but you know, basically our spreadsheet, here's our project list. All right, how do we rank these in order? And you know, I think this is our first step in that direction. So I hope that helps answer. Are there any categories or things that maybe I've looked over?
So this doesn't really apply to stormwater and sewer.
No, not
mostly
yet.
Mostly roads?
No, my idea is let the majority of our projects in number, especially in dollar amount, is on transportation. So how do we rank those? And I would say let's go through that exercise, and then we can take a look at the others. And those may just be more informational to the BOC. We might be able to take that. I think sewer's pretty straightforward. Stormwater is yet to be seen as we go through the study on that. I think it'll.
So, where
up.
Would the four way at Beckwith and South Rutland fall in? What category?
So like, I would say signalization.
So, which is
congestion
that?
Congestion as well.
Mm-hmm.
Congestion?
Yep.
And as well as Beckwith Road?
I would say for Beckwith Road, I would say it's probably a mix between safety, congestion, and economic opportunity.
And then sidewalks, I guess, would be under grants.
So, primarily, yes, but you know, Matt, you had a good point earlier talking about sidewalks. If you've got people walking today on a side of a road, that's a safety problem. While it might not be a documented crash history that we would have on a roadway, that still has some safety merit to it. So while it might not get the full score on the safety, I think it deserves some score on the safety.
I see people all the time walking in the gutter on Lebanon Road where we don't have sidewalks. Obvious safety issue.
So if you have something you want to address, but it could fall into really three categories, how could you fairly rate it, like for specific projects?
So the idea, well, I think if you had a project that would score well in several different areas, you have a project that's going to be higher on the priority list. So don't think of it as a project that's purely for safety or purely for congestion. Think of it as a project that may have elements of safety, may have elements of congestion, may have elements of connectivity, and it's going to score well on all three of those. And then if it by chance got some grant money, then all of a sudden it's going to shoot up to the top of the list. It might not exist today, and it might shoot up to the top of the list next year, depending on what happens.
The primary driver for this is for roads.
Yes.
Yeah. Sidewalks in some of these projects could be a byproduct of putting in.
We're going to score them under the same.
But this is not anything to do with sidewalks.
No. Okay. But I think what you're going to end up with, and I put it down there in the bottom, projects will only be compared against one another based on project type. So you got three main types: roadways, signals, and bike ped. So we're going to put those into their own categories. We're not going to score them against each other in one big pot. Because what happens, we get the grant money, and the grant money, like what we had just were awarded, really is only going to apply to greenways and signals. There may be some other extraneous type stuff. But so that grant money is not available for widening a roadway. So therefore, we need to have a priority of saying this is our top signal project, or this is our top bike ped project. That way we can go in and go, when we go into these competitions, we don't necessarily have to say that, well, it scored a 75 out of 100. That doesn't sound great, but it's our top greenway project. We can state this is our priority. This is our numbered priority. And so we're not going to compare a top greenway project to a top roadway project. That comes when we bring it before y'all to the into the budget. And we know what's, I mean, and we've talked about this before, but we're not going to be coming up here when we know we've got congestion needs. That's a livability need today. But a greenway, in my opinion, is a livability need for, yes, it's good living. It's what I consider, I like to call greenways linear parks. So that's a benefit and an asset to the community, but it's not an inconvenience that we're having to deal with today that we're trying to offset. So let's try to get those, but then at the same time, okay, well, we'll get some grant money on a greenway. Now we're talking, and that pushes that up, and let's leverage that grant money. Always leverage the grant money, but given the choice between the two of them, knowing what our main issues are, what we have to deal with on a day-to-day basis, I say the roadway projects are always going to come out. When it comes out with budgeting time and saying which project are we going to put to construction this year, we're going to fully fund a greenway, or we're going to fully fund a roadway. Well, the choice is simple. The choice is going to be the roadway. And so that's why I don't want to necessarily compare a greenway project to a roadway project. I want to compare greenways against greenways and roadways against roadways and then signals against signals. And so that way, that's the way to think about it. So these criteria, the signal system might not do great for connectivity or economic opportunity ever, but that's fine. It doesn't have to. We won't worry about that. We're just scoring them against one another. I hope that helps explain that.
Mm-hmm. I have a quick question.
Yeah.
So, for example, in the city, I mean, because the city has obviously done some type of transportation case study, correct? And that's going to kind of already generate this same evaluation that we're gonna give you based off of what little bit of information that we got from you today. So, in my opinion, obviously, we can give you a list of what we think is gonna be great, but in reality, that case study's gonna be very important for us, correct? That's the way I would see this.
Well, probably what I'd say, so, we've done two things traditionally. We've had a smattering of plans in the past. And by transportation plans, I'd say we had the 98 major thoroughfare plan, and then we've had some land use transportation plans along the way that relied on transportation. And then we had our our actual transportation plan passed in 2020. And so that is what I would say is our foundation for what we do, but that doesn't fund projects. And it's just a plan, and that plan can change as far as priorities, dollar amounts, what a project looks like. Is it a 5-lane roadway? Is it a 3-lane roadway? That stuff can change, but then beyond that, on a year-to-year basis, it's our budget. It's our budget that has been driving these, saying, okay, here's our needs. Let's establish our needs. We've had so many obvious needs in the past. We've really just been trying to struggle to get those projects going. But those came out of plans, like Golden Bear Gateway. That came out of the 98 Major Thoroughfare Plan. That was identified in that. And so it took until 2017 to finally get finished. Now, there's still elements of it that we need to finish to Lebanon Road, true. But as far as having the alignment done, yes. So, but that was kind of our idea of that plan. And then this is really, I'll say to date, we've never had a true capital improvement plan. That has never existed, as far as I know of, in our city's history. So this is where I'm wanting to... What's that?
Capital improvement plans?
Mm-hmm.
It's never existed?
Correct.
Well,
at least
yeah.
For transportation.
Actually, transportation was in mixed in with it, but it was a capital improvement plan that was based on the pocket plan for the sewer, traffic. There were lots of elements that were mixed into it. What happened to it? Obviously, nothing, if you look at our traffic situation. But, you know, it was done. I didn't know that.
Do you know about when? Because I've not found that.
I'd have to think about it, and right now I'm not 100% to think about anything.
To my understanding, no capital improvement, a true capital improvement plan has ever been done for transportation.
Like I said, what happened to it, I don't have a clue. It would have been around 2002 or 2003.
Now, I did find the 2003 bike ped plan. There was a 2003 bike ped greenway plan. So that was done. But that, again, wasn't funding. It was just the setting priorities and setting what greenway network and sidewalk network could look like.
Andy, I'm not going to put all this on your back. I'm just going to tell you that I have zero faith that anything that we talk about tonight will be done during my lifetime, especially, I mean, the older people like Scott, you know, there's no way that, you know this stuff will be during his lifetime. No, you're not. You're an old soul. Just live with it. But I just don't have any faith. TDOT's not going to allow it to happen, obviously. They get in their way more than they get anything accomplished. So, and I don't care, by the way, if Channel 17 runs that. I'll get some more phone calls.
There you go. Well, what I would say with this is that I'd say the biggest outcome of this is not necessarily reliance on TDOT. I would say the biggest outcome of this is how do we do our projects. Those projects, I think, need to be in here because we've got to compare those. And truth be told, we have some money that we're spending on those. But as far as bringing projects to completion, it's the City of Mount Juliet moving forward for what we're going to do for our projects. And then that brings the next question up, how are we going to pay for them? And that's the question that we at least need to, once we get through this plan, we need to be thinking about.
Well, let me say this. It's kind of the elephant in the room. And again, this is not a reflection of you because it wasn't your baby. Other than Golden Bear Gateway, we haven't completed any road projects in years. I mean, the projects that are stifling us are still stifling us. We have Providence with South Mount Juliet Road. Maybe it'll be done in 5 years. Who in the world knows? We know that Lebanon Road
will be, I would be shocked if it's done in 5 years, they've been working on it for 7 years, a mile section to widen. And that mile section to widen actually is costing the city or taxpayers almost the same amount that it took to build the entire Golden Bear Gateway to the Interstate 11 Road. I think it was within $2 million. It was 23 million for that, and 21 million is what's estimated costs for the 11 Road widening project. Widening 1 mile versus how many miles is Golden Bear? Five, six miles. Building 6 miles of road that we did, by the way, for the most part. I have no faith in our ability to get any roads done, or get anything accomplished. Yeah, I go to church, Joy Church, and of course I drive that area all the time. You get stuck right at West Wilson Utility District, and it's 15, 20 minutes before you can get to Business Area Road. And obviously, Tennessee Department of Transportation could care less that that's a problem. It's not anything on their radar, although it's been on ours for a while. So, when you get this back from me, it's going to have one piece, and it's going to be Lebanon Road from Kangaroo to City Limits. So, and by the way, any updates on that?
We have had the preliminary field review, which is going over the preliminary plans. The environmental document has been submitted to TDOT. Comments received in a very good, timely fashion, might I add.
Back from TDOT?
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
Yeah, oh yeah. And then those comments are now being worked on, and we'll be
readdressed. What were those comments? Did we find a snail darter, an Indiana brown bat? I mean,
it was mostly programmatic type stuff.
It was what?
There was no major comments on it. It was all just documentation related.
Prompted, I'm sure, by the fact that we went out and got federal money to help the project along, right?
That's the whole purpose of the NEPA document. It's federal.
So disgusting.
Yeah. Well, we're about almost 10 minutes past. I think we got a guest here.
Yes, you going to go into that?
Somebody's got anything else any other questions on this?
Thank you guys for your time tonight.
Only thing I'd say is just provide your score on here and provide it back to me, please.
Thanks, Andy. Just rank them 1 through 7.
This week, if you can.
Most priority.